Smith of Ireland, triple gold medalist in 5. Chun Yun of China in 6. Haruna of Japan in 7. And Yu Li Min of China in lane 8.
Starting the night, the USA have a total of 22 medals, 10 gold, 10 silver, and 2 bronze. They finished in Barcelona with 27, 11 gold, 9 silver, and 7 bronze, so they can surpass their total of 10 gold tonight. But our interest in the centre lanes here, lanes 4 and 3, Petria Thomas and Susie O'Neill, a chance for Australia, perhaps, to grab a couple of medals.
There's the girls on the screen in the middle of the centre of the pool, lanes 3 and 4.
Neil Brooks is down near the action. Neil?
This is quite bizarre, Dennis. If you notice, I'm down on pool deck at the moment. No Michelle Smith. She hasn't come out yet. They're starting to introduce the competitors behind the block. And the girl from Ireland is missing. There's officials running down here frantically, trying to find the triple Olympic gold medalist. But at this stage, she doesn't appear to be anywhere around. There's a little bit of confusion down here on the deck. People are running quite frantically around here on the pool deck. She's due to swim out of lane 5 at this stage. Oh, here she comes now. She's just walking out now, and hopefully at the end of the race, it's not the time to talk about it with her now, we'll find out what happened. But she does tend to look a little bit distressed, and we'll have to see how the race eventuates and what the problem is with her not walking out with the other competitors.
Quite remarkable. Michelle Smith then, out last, well and truly, looking for number 4 at these games. There's Petria, very impressive this morning. Second to Susie at the trials in 4.12.33. She swam 2.10.64 to win her heat this morning.
A great swimmer. She trains with Gennady Turetsky. She's just come off altitude training where she trained under Mark Reagan. It seems to have worked for her. She did her best time. Let's hope she can do it.
Alongside her, the fastest qualifier this morning. Finally, can she and Australia break through? The bronze medalist in Barcelona, and she started then from lane 4. A chance for Australia. Women's 200 fly, they've taken their marks and away. Susie dwelt just a fraction, Smith away well, Petria also quickly into stroke. They've covered about 15 metres, now Susie is coming on, she's looking strong, Petria alongside. About a metre back to Smith, across in lane 1, Jackson going quickly as well.
We saw Petria go fast this morning. Susie looks fantastic. At the Pan Pacific Championships, up until 150 metres, she was on world record pace, so she is capable of doing this.
O'Neill in lane 4 will take them around. She does, and the time there, 28.54.
Under world record pace.
Across in 1, Jackson is not far away. Back down the pool now. O'Neill, Thomas would be half a body length away, back in about 4th place, so the Australians looking terrific at the moment. O'Neill coming through in 5 is Michelle Smith, across in 8, Liu, not to be discounted. The Chinese girl would be up there now disputing 3rd place, and Petria's coming on.
Susie and Petria look fantastic. They both have got a great rhythm going. They should go round in about a minute one.
100 metres to swim then.
Under world record pace again for Susie. Hopefully she can sustain this, but she looks great.
Australians first and fourth, O'Neill in front. Alongside her, Smith, the sensation of these games, just behind them. At Susie's feet there is Thomas. Across in lane 8, it's Liu. O'Neill in front. Now it starts to get tough. Here comes Smith, O'Neill, Smith, and back to Thomas in 3rd place. About 60 metres to swim. The turn here, absolutely essential.
This is where it starts to get difficult. The lactic acid will be building up. She needs to work this turn and she'll bring it home.
Come on, Susie. We've got to start.
Great turn,
out by
from
about
Susie.
A metre. She leads Smith. Petria would be in 3rd place. Coming on the outside is Liu. It's O'Neill in front. She's starting to move away. She's out by half a body length. Liu in 8th, the danger. Smith is there as well. They're both plugging on. Petria just dropping off the pace. It's O'Neill in front. She's going to win gold for Australia. She's out by a body length. Susie O'Neill, the heart of a lion in the heart of Dixie. Look at this. She's pulling away. What a terrific swim. Finally, gold to Australia.
Oh, what a fantastic swim. We really thought Smith would be right up there. 2.07.76. Petria Thomas has come in second. 2.09.82. Fantastic race from those girls.
What a finish by Thomas.
That is unbelievable. We knew Petrea looked great this morning. She's done another best time, taken another second off her best time. But Susie O'Neill, we really thought Smith would come up on her at the end.
Look at that margin. O'Neill the winner, 2:07.76. Thomas by 9/100ths of a second. Smith was third. And across in lane eight, Liu has finished, what's that? My maths aren't too good. About 4/100ths of a second. No, 4/0/100ths of a second.
Whew. Fantastic race by Susie. She just kept pulling away 25 metres from home, and she just still looked fantastic.
Wow.
Our first gold in the pool.
Gold and silver. Amazing.
Amazing indeed. Susie O'Neill, you little beauty. 2:07.76. Patria Thomas, the silver. 2:09.82. Michelle Smith of Ireland, a bronze to add to her three gold. Coming up, more gold medals here at the Georgia Tech Aquatic Centre in Atlanta. And straight after the break, the latest on the Centennial Park.
Exactly. I mean, when you went out that fast, there was a bit of a question of you hanging on, but you just pulled away in the last 25. Fantastic effort.
Yeah, I had no idea where anyone was. I was worried about Lim and Lou out in the outside lane, but Scott Volker's my coach, who I'd like to give a big rat to, by the way. He just told me that look at the wall, look at the boxes. That's how I was looking at the black boxes at the end of the pool.
Patria, yourself, you were disappointed you missed out on making the team in the 100. You come here, you've done a bit more work now, a silver medal in an Olympic final in your non-preferred event.
I can't complain about this, you know. I mean, I didn't get to swim the 100, but silver medal makes up for all that.
Yourself, a bit of a contrast to this morning, that you came home like a train. You swam over the top of Michelle Smith and the girl from China.
I don't know. I suppose it's the Olympic Games that helps you along there. I don't know where that energy came from.
What were you thinking before the race? What was your plan?
You know, I wanted to get a medal, but I was just going in there to swim my own race and have a good time.
Susie, so many times, bronze medals, silver medals, world championship placings, now the ultimate. This is the only one that counts now?
Oh, definitely. All those bronzes and fifths and everything, just throw them aside. This is what I've been aiming for all my swimming career, and I've reached it, so I'm just ecstatic.
So many times people have said about the size of the program that you take on. I mean, obviously put that rest tonight.
Yeah, I think that really helped me this meet. Gave me a lot of race practice, made me comfortable. I thought I was going to be really nervous for it, but when I got out there, I felt fine. So I think that was from doing so many races beforehand.
Michelle Smith, three gold medals. She seemed unbeatable, but you've finally tamed the girl from Ireland.
Yeah, I think fly's not her best, you know, stroke. I saw her in the medley, and I was still very worried about what she'd do, but I was just trying to swim my own race, and luckily we both ended up in front of her, so.
Girls, have you got people back home you'd like to say hello to?
I've got to say hello to my sister Catherine, because I didn't say hello, and Mum and Dad, and everyone having fun at my house because my parents are back there.
I've got heaps of people, Kate and Amanda, my flatmates, all the people back in Canberra that have supported me, and of course my hometown of Mullumbimby. Hi to everyone.
Congratulations, Olympic gold and silver medalists. Well done, girls.
Thank you.
Susie and Patria doing it for Australia, and it's what the big contingent of Australian fans had been longing for 7 days at the Georgia Tech Aquatic Centre, and these two young girls finally delivered the goods. Let's go to the medal ceremony now for the women's 200 metres butterfly. Gold and silver as Australia saved its best for last.
A magic moment. The two Australians centre stage, Susie O'Neill and Petrea Thomas.
What a moment this is.
As it was in Barcelona, had to wait till the last day. Australia's first gold, and with that they equal their tally from Barcelona. Identical as things stand at the moment.
Petrea's been training at the Institute of Sport in Canberra for years. I'm sure there are a lot of people there that are just delighted to have seen this, and everyone from her home coach at Ballina Indoor.
Sandy was talking in the introduction about her hometown. I missed the name, but wherever it is, I'm sure they're very misty-eyed tonight. Australia begin the last night going 1-2, gold and silver in the women's.
And wasn't it great to see that both Susie and Kieran actually know the words to the Australian national anthem, which a lot of people don't. Traditionally, the final event at the Olympic.
Still and Kate Slatter.
Australia in the United States! Yes! Oh. Yes!